Today we are going to talk about the mature Harappan phase, the mature Harappan phase of the Harappan civilization, spanning a chronological period of 2600 to 1900 BC. Now, before we talk about this phase, which actually saw the efflorescence of the civilization, we need to look back. I would like to take you back to an earlier phase of 3200 to 2600 BC, a phase which archaeologists have called the pre or early Harappan. By this they mean these various rural settlements dotting the geographical expanse of land in modern Pakistan, Afghanistan and Balochistan, rural settlements where Mehrgarh is one of the most important sites which was explored and excavated for various seasons. You must be all aware of the site of Mehrgarh. Now, archaeologists trying to understand the mature Harappan phase look for the origins or roots of the mature Harappan in these earlier rural settlements, which are called the pre and the early Harappan cultures. They see the germs in the house building methods, in the use of terracotta, in the various subsistence patterns.
The remains of the Indus or the Harappan civilization can be found in India, Pakistan and Afghanistan. These sites range from urban centers to rural settlements, craft centers, campsites and a few probable ports. Though spread over such vast area, there is cohesiveness in some aspects of the Harappan civilization. One can discern some universal characteristics or Indus features in most of these centers. This raises many questions. Was it a large kingdom with smaller townships? Was there a central authority that determined a certain way of life? In this program, we shall deal with economy, agriculture, craft, technology, and trade.
First aspect that I would like to take up is subsistence. Now, as we have already seen, there is a vast diversity of geographical regions covered by the mature Harappan phase. So, what is the nature of subsistence patterns, or what are the different subsistence patterns that we are finding in this vast geographical expanse of land? Now, there are two sciences on which archaeologists depend: the sciences of paleobotany and archaeozoology, looking at floral and faunal analysis respectively, helping archaeologists to understand the past adaptation patterns. Now, the significant major river of the greater Indus region is, of course, the Indus. That is the drainage system. To the west of the Indus, you have this huge tract of land across West Asia, where there is a practice of growing agricultural crops, the rabi crops like wheat and barley, and you also come across certain animal species which were raised, which were domesticated, like cattle, goat, sheep, etc. So it is quite natural to find Harappans relying on some of these agricultural rabi crops like wheat, barley. Apart from that, lentil, mustard, peas, linseed, gram, etc. Now, the Harappan region also lies on the western margins of the southwestern monsoon zone of West Asia, and therefore you also come across some summer crops like the sesamum, cotton, as well as the summer growing rice and millets. Then bear and date seeds have been identified, as well as beans which grew throughout the year. So you find quite a diverse agricultural pattern in this region. Fiber and oil were extracted from cotton and sesamum.